Thank you. When I was 5 years old, I first heard the harp. My mother used to play the flute as a hobby, and one day she took me with her to a friend. I just went along to a swing on the swing, play in the garden, and all of a sudden I heard this sound that was familiar to me. And I jumped off the swing, it sort of lured me. I went upstairs, and there it was, and I saw it for the first time, the harp. And the sound just went right through me and embraced me. And from that moment, it was clear to me that I wanted to play it. And not only that, I wanted to become the best harpist in the world. So I started studying 8 hours a day, 7 days a week. And 20 years later, I was 25 and I was living this dream. I was touring the world, playing about 200 concerts a year with all the great orchestras in beautiful venues in the classical music world. And I was a bit surprised because I was living this dream. I thought it was my dream, and yet I felt very unhappy. And I didn't know what was the reason. And at that time, I was finishing my studies in Paris, and my teacher, after 20 years of studying the harp, was the first who asked me, "Why actually do you make music?" And I realized no one had ever asked me this question. And me, myself, I had taken it for granted. I just climbed the ladder of the career of a harpist and trying to become better and better. And this question was a shock, because I couldn't continue. And I had to stop. I canceled all my future engagements. I realized that maybe playing all the music that was written by the great composers in the past was just not enough for me, and I had to find out what my music was, what my story was, why I want to make music. I stepped away from the harp, and I went into electronics, into loops, and I didn't play with a string quartet in the Concertgebouw, but I turned the string quartet into a band with a drummer, with a synthesizer guy, with brass, and sort of discovered what my music would sound like. Isabelle Moretti, who was my teacher in Paris, she always told me to be patient, to be quiet, to listen to what is inside of you, because she said and she was convinced that everything you want, everything you desire, is already inside of you, and you just need the patience and, well, the quietness for it to come out. And while I'll play my next piece for you, which I wrote with one of my all-time pop heroes, Fink, who worked with Amy Winehouse and John Legend, which we recorded earlier this year, I want to ask you this question. What is it that is inside of you that you maybe need patience for and that is waiting to come out? Thank you so much.